Yesu asem.
Because you want to go and buy alcohol and drink.
Esa so bezo mo no sangoro ti.
You are happy to join the occasion.
Eh, when you just remove the affection,
you don't understand everything of it.
Now, so you will be able to do what you.
Amen.
Amen.
So now, we have checked correctly.
They say, "Who are you?"
Our faith is right.
Did you hear that?
There is something spiritual waiting for us. Something the spiritual that the Lord has prepared for us. I go to prepare a place for you. And when I am done, I will come back again. And I will take you with me. Where I am, there you shall be. We will sit on a table and dine together. We have not seen it. But because of this evidence that Jesus came to die, we know it will happen.
Amen.
So now,
it is the same.
Who is going to lead us to this kingdom? That is a question that I and you should ask ourselves. The Bible says Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father except through
Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Now that Jesus. How are you going to believe in the person who can take you to Jesus? For you to know the way. Amen.
Amen.
This is what is putting most of Christians in hell. We have had the faith of. We know heaven is there. The kingdom of God is existing. But where can we pass and go there? We know Jesus Christ is the way. Even though we know some of them doesn't know He's the way. But we Christians, we know He's the way. That is where the belief comes in. So now your faith is sure.
So
but to believe in the person who will take you there, that has been a battle. Amen.
Amen.
Is the Lord teaching me anew? Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Muslims will tell you that they are going through Muhammad. They are going to Allah through Muhammad. They are going to heaven. Roman Catholic, they also say they are going to, through
Mary.
Everybody says they are going to heaven. But which way are we passing? If we manage to believe in Jesus, that is the way. Then, those who are leading us through Jesus, how are we sure that they are leading us through Jesus? So, this has been a big problem. And so many people are going to hell because of this. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
This year ending, the Lord wants you to rethink again. Pray over that your leader. And make sure he's taking you to heaven. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you a story.
Make her assembly trouble.
2 years ago, we went to Ghana.
If you mean what you call my gun.
And as we were visiting my hometown.
Now you call my crew, we were free.
As we were driving towards the road.
And now we're going to swear airport.
We got to a place called Eninem. And that place, if you get there, they sell so many bush meat. Glass cutter, special. So when I got there, I
packed. You can't see, baby.
I wanted to buy some glass cutter. Amen. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So the moment I packed and started rolling the window down, I'm telling you, thousands of black catastrophes.
Ajay,
every one of them is holding glass
catastrophes. Let me ask you an example. Akratia.
Amen.
Amen.
Life once.
Jehovah.
Dead once. Roasted ones. They all jumped to the car at once. And they started putting the meat in the car. Buy mine. Mine is good. I'm not going to be able to do it. And I bought from a guy. When I got to my hometown,
he got room with room.
The glass cutter had came.
Oh, I can't hear say. I bought you.
What are we saying?
Is it any other?
So many people are witnessing Jesus.
This
is my advice.
Yes, we knew.
This is the way I come. Come.
Come
and join the few. How are you sure that they are taking you there? Do you believe
it will be done?
Amen.
Amen.
You may be having faith, all right. Then you are going to heaven. There is something they prepared for you. But because of the car you joined, because of the group you joined, you will be landed somewhere. The Lord communicated to me.
Amen.
Amen. Do you understand?
That's what
I said. I am going to heaven. I have this hope. I have this faith. I know Jesus Christ. He meant it for me there. Devil has been laid. So many food. So many we have the faith and we think that is it. Someone leading you can take you where you don't want to go.
Pray
to be very sure at the end of this year. Next year, find that your leader is that person taking you to heaven.
Amen.
You go to Roman Catholic Church. And you also say you are going to heaven. Pray. Is Pope taking me to heaven? The faith you have, the faith, alright. But the person who is taking you is where the problem lies. I bought a rotten glass cutter.
Oh, I can't hear you saying I'm toy.
And I am sure there were some of them that were good.
We did this every one man.
But because I didn't check.
That's
everyone was bringing their own.
Yeah, yeah,
and I did not have time to check
them. Yeah, yeah,
and I end up buying
the
bad one.
Oh. Yeah, say.
Brethren, if you're not careful, you will end up buying a bad one. But your destination is in heaven. But what happened? because you did not check
well.
Pray over that your pastor. Pray over that your bishop. Pray over that your overseer. Pray over that your what are them?
Prophet.
Your prophet.
Evangelist.
Your evangelist. Your apostles. Pray over them and see if they are taking you to heaven. See if they are taking you to where you want to go. Before you join them.
And son, what do you want to achieve?
If they are not going your way, get off. It is not by force. Find a different car.
You should come from
and join them.
Not what you're doing.
Stop communicating to me.
Anymore.
So you may have faith, all right. But you will end up somewhere that you don't want. Brother, let me tell you something. Do you know that anywhere that we find ourselves, it is because of the teaching from that place. That will take her to heaven or not. It is not the person. It is the teachings. If the Lord opens your understanding, it is not the person, but the teachings. Anything that they will tell you, you are ready to do. Because you have the faith, you want to go to heaven. So anything they tell you, you do. Are they telling you the right thing? Or they are telling you the wrong things? Are they telling you everything? Or they are hiding some things from you. So if you find yourself in hellfire and you call yourself a Christian, then it is not your fault, but it is where you were. It is the ministry that you find yourself in. It is the ministry that you were worshipping in. Because they didn't taught you the right things. Because they didn't open your eyes in some things. Because they tried to hide the truth from you. So many things they did not tell you. You did not know. You find yourself in hellfire. Are you seeing how important it is to find someone who is leading you? To make sure this person is taking you to heaven.
Amen.
When we went to Ghana last year for the crusade,
a few times when I called Ghana for a crusade, you know,
I observed something. We went to the open station. Pastor Lady wanted to go and buy something in Manasseh.
No, so my person only in your bus at one time.
So I was sitting in the car waiting for them.
It's me, I'm not the car, you know,
hey, women, I wait, they are not coming.
I'm not sure, I'm not.
I said, what is going on?
I'm sitting here.
What are these women going to
do? I'm not here. No more.
That they are not coming. Look at where I have parked. I don't want to give people to come and give me. So I was sitting.
Brother, you
know. Something just pushed me out from the car.
Maybe the PM free car.
And I went into the main station.
The
Lord spoke to me that observed something there. So I was observing something. And there were these people that load the coaches. They load. When you are coming, they say, hey, Magasin, come here. You can see about four cars. They are all going to
Kumase.
And these people have to struggle and load. It's like it's not first time person.
When you say what very can happen,
the more you can talk.
So it's a big cassa.
The more you can rap. People will come
in. When you have a flow,
and I heard some guy saying,
Come,
this driver has full license. Come. accident. Because that driver is qualified. He's a qualified driver to take you to Takrade. Experienced driver to take you to Takrade. Without having an accident on the way. Brother, I am telling you, is your preacher having the full gospel? That will take you to heaven. That you will not have an accident on the way. Make sure you search and find out where you are. If they are not taking you to heaven, pack your things. You have faith in the Lord, but do you have belief in your leader? These children will tell you this. Are you going to say you at is it 50-50 or 100%? Is that preacher having full license or provisional?
Do they
know what the Lord wants? Do they know what will take you to heaven? When you check and then you get to know, then you believe in that person, that that person can surely take you to my destination.
Amen.
Are you getting it?
What he has here?
Jesus Christ told Peter.
Yes, we got your Petro.
Peter.
I see Petro.
Satan has asked for you. But I have prayed for you. So that your faith, listen to very carefully, your faith will not fail. You have a faith, Peter. You have a faith that something has prepared for you. But Satan is asking you. If I will not pray for you, Satan will get hold of you. And that's your faith that you have to go to heaven. It will end you up in hell. Therefore, I have prayed for you so that you will not be disappointed. But when I fully gave you,
Jesus,
I am the way. I have the full license to take you to heaven. When I fully gave you, then you also strengthen your
faith.
You will also be a leader that I have sent to lead my people.
Amen.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
If we will not assess our leaders, we will continue to go to hell. The faith we have is different. Going to heaven is also different. Who is taking you there? Is that person qualified? Is that person knows the way? Or because he's mentioning the name Jesus. Because you hear Kumasi. Is that driver having a full license? And you run and join them. You will be in trouble. Brethren, it is up to me and you.
And you know, Jimmy also.
To make sure that the faith that we have will be complete. By knowing who is leading us and trusting in that person. How is your pastor? By your
astute.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Mi pabe show. Wasa ase so. Ni pa beshe wa sa Amen. The kind of church we find ourselves in The kind of teachings we are receiving. The kind of things we have been told that we should ignore. Amen.
Amen.
The things that God wants us to do. That some preachers is telling us to ignore them. Brethren, this is the time we need to fix our Christian life again. The Lord has given me and you another privilege to know this truth and once again assess our life again. Assess our leaders again. And finally, they are truly taking us
together.
If they are not taking us, then we should find a different way. We should find someone whom we will believe. Someone who has the truthful, full message of the Lord to take us to the kingdom of
God.
Glory be to Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And the Lord spoke to me. Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Now go with me very quickly, you finish very quickly to the book of St. John, chapter 1. We are going to read from the verse 11. John chapter 1, 11. The Bible says, he kept his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God. Amen.
Amen.
He kept his own, but his own did not believe him. But as many as believed in him, they was given the right to become the children of God. Giving the right to become a child of God does not make you a child of God. Are you getting that? If you are given the chance to become a child of God, it is an offer given to you. Do you want to proceed or not? Amen.
Amen.
Some people have been living in this country 20 years, 30 years. They still don't have British passport. They are all in
there.
Why is it that? The chance was given to them. After some period, you have the right to become a citizen of this country. But it was an option. But they said, no, we don't want to
become.
We still want to be the guy in the country. So the Bible is telling us something. As many as believe in Jesus. But you continue, he says. The first one says, as many as receive. Or
jail.
Amen.
Amen.
He kept his own. His boss says, no, we don't like you go. But somebody said, come. Come and live in my house. Come and stay here. The Bible said, because we received him to our house, he gave us the chance. He gave us the option. He opened that door to become children of God. It is up to me and you. Or not. So the second part says, Receiving Jesus is different from believing in his name. So, brethren, don't let get this twisted. If we want to go to heaven, we need to believe in Jesus and also believe in the one who is taking us.
Amen.
Are you getting it? Jesus will not fly from heaven and come that person, come and let's go. No. But he will use someone that he has given the full authority. Act on my behalf. Stay here. Act. On my behalf. How do you know that person? That is why so many people are tripping to
him.
You will see them, they will tell Jesus, I've sent us.
Oh, I say yes, was mommy.
They are lying to
you.
Check the message. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Is the message that taking me to heaven? This message. Not the man. The man might be maybe a deceiver. But the deception will come through his message. So when you see that the message is not corresponding to Jesus Christ, what he wants us to do, then find your way out.
It is also the same way Papa said, Jesus Christ, my brother.
This is our homework to do at the end of this. So that by next year we will know the right person to take us to
heaven.
Glory be to you. Let this be your burden. So that you can take up daily. Pray to the Lord daily. For him to show you his
son.
Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Is the Lord speaking to me anymore? So the Bible says, we did those who received Jesus Christ. Some people within them not receive him alone, but also believe in his name. And the Bible says, those are the people who were born, not of blood, not of the will of the flesh, not of the will of man, but of God.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
So when you come to believe in Jesus,
so what is Jesus dear?
Then you are born not of blood. You are born not of flesh. You are born not of man. But you are born of God.
Amen.
Those who believe. So this is all the people are here now.
And you want to say maybe we're some other. Oh.
So sad.
Hey, Arabosan.
So sad.
Arabosan.
Amen.
Amen.
So brethren, this is what God is telling us.
It's in your own country.
Our faith is right. A Christian faith.
A Christian faith.
A Christian faith.
Christian faith.
To take to heaven. No mistake about that. But who is taking you? This is a homework for everyone of us. Glory be to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
May the Lord bless his way. In Jesus' mighty name. Say amen.
Amen.
Let us open our mouth and pray. May the Lord help us so we will know. If
you
find out that person is
catapulted,
then you run away.
That
person is scary. That person is double-minded. That person is two-faced. Then you run away. If not, our faith
will
fail us.
Amen.
Do you know there are so many people because of what their leader have done? They are not even interested to worship the Lord again. Amen.
Amen.
They are not interested. Because of what someone has done, they have missed it. Their faith has failed them. They were having the faith all right. But I didn't have faith. The devil came and sent them away. Because of where they find themselves. Brethren, don't let your faith, your faith fail you. Search for where the right person is. Follow them to where you are. Brethren, it is not any church that you go there and take you to heaven. And you cannot stay in your house and say, I'm staying in my house and go to heaven. You need someone to lead you. Because that is what the Bible has said. So, find who will lead you. Find who will lead you. And make sure you will not miss it. Let us pray. Open your mouth and pray. Say, Jesus, I have come before you. I have faith in you. Even though I've not seen it, but the evidence is clear. I know you are the way, but you are not here at the moment. You told that you have sent your servants to come, and they will come and show us the way. They will stand in the gap of you to bring us to your Father's house. Therefore we pray, Father, help us, open our eyes, let us know where we are. If it is not of you, then you will change and continue to look for another place. I pray that you help me to do this selection so that I will not enter into hell. I don't want to go to hell. It is not my portion. So Jesus, help me. Show me your servants. Your truthful servants. That will bring me to you. So that I can come to you without having an accident. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
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 The Lord bless all of us. And decide correctly. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. What a word. Amen. What are we saying to our pastor?
God bless.
It's like, your God bless you, is sick. What are you saying to our pastor? God bless you, pastor. Amen. Amen. That was wonderful. That was wonderful. Let us know where we are, because it is very important. Very important. May the Lord be our help. Shall we please pray over our fight and our offerings? If we are fighting, then let us pray over our fight, as well as our offering, please.